or they can do their own animation at home, but to contribute to something which that, or the stories that you're talking about, which needs a larger team, which needs a larger force. I'm not saying strength-wise, but every department-wise, or a particular domain of every animation. So there are people in it. So only one can't do all. That way everybody complements everybody else's expertise in that particular domain.
No, but just out of curiosity, see like a Chintu what you showed, right?
Yeah.
The Chintu character is fixed, that Mini character is fixed, Raju, Bandai, all those characters are fixed. And you, if you create a library of their movements, that's it. And you keep it on your cloud and let people just download and create multiple animations out of this at their home. So the artist is taken care of, the story is there like a library, and then just pull it out and they put their voice and shoot. And it's just the idea.
We have never thought of this. It could be possible. By and by, as in, let's say we have started working on Chintu now. So let's say next 2 or 3 years, we would have our own presets and libraries of expressions and emotions and attitude poses and something like that, which could be automated. It's an idea to think about. Yeah.
Two questions here. You mentioned that you started off as a proprietary firm and then you were taken over. After a couple of years, and then you also mentioned that it didn't really work out. Today, when you look back at those times, what would you have done differently to avoid that sort of a unpleasant situation? And the second question is, since you work in the film industry, are you yourself a huge film buff? Do you watch a lot of films, whether animation or live action? Since your childhood, have you been a film buff?
Yeah. So, answer to first question of yours is, would I have done any differently then? I don't know. I wouldn't have. Probably I wouldn't have speculated those numbers, which were speculation by the end of the days. But yeah, I don't want to get into the story much, but to justify myself, if I may, this venture was not working out, was decided by those invested within first 6 months of the time, which is no time at all. Whatever that we were trying to do or setting up things would itself take more than a year. Even if it's my business or somebody else's, I feel in terms of animation or visual effects, 3 to 4 years is pretty much a gestation period that you try and, just exist for that particular amount of time. Your quality, your deliverables, the respect and the goodwill is like a 10-year plan. So in that manner, I don't think I would have done anything differently. Now I do because I'm not going to do it again. So that is one. And in terms of films, I'm quite a movie buff. But pretty much watch every film, even if it's Hindi film. Yeah.
I have seen this 3D Chintu animation on Toolbox website somewhere down the line. So I just wanted to know whether who holds the rights of 3D animation of it, or because of course the Chintu is the one character I would like to see animated. I have my own small setup of studio, and I also want to ask you that ki, why didn't you go for your own character? What I see here is ki Chintu is somehow like an inheritance to you. So why there was no new character from your, in a way you slammed Chota Bheem while you said you don't want to slam it. So what is the reason behind it?
First question, as in the first answer to your question is, I started Toolbox and we acquired rights in 2009, which were there for 3 years. With Toolbox, they are not anymore. So I have reacquired those rights in 2012. So that 3D animation has been done at that time, which were some of the tests that we were trying to do. And the next thing is, Chota Bheem is an exception. But if you see any other character, no other character has clicked with people. As in, the way I see it, there are a lot of emotions and relative. Those characters have to be relatable. So that you can identify yourself with that particular thing. And to have a property like that, which has been in existence for last 20 years, is a pretty rare case by itself. It has no boundaries, even though it was in Marathi for 16 years, and after that in Marathi and Kannada and English after that. So they proved that it is not limited to one particular language. And to have such a character which has no relation with the politics, which is not commenting on your daily issues. It's a plain, simple, funny, witty character, which is living his own life. And there are certain learnings of it, which are basically depends on what, you know, family values and stuff like that, or simple lost pleasures of life. So I thought this is a great property to work on. Chintu by itself have changed over 20 years in terms of look and feel or whatever. Animation might take him into different directions, but the crux of Chintu is the magic of that property itself. So I don't want to lose out on it. And I don't see the property into a space which is 30-minute or 23-minute TV episodic. I don't see that at all. It's a cartoon strip, and it will always remain like that. So which are 30, 40, 50 or 60-second stories, which you can probably see it on your mobile every day or have it on your tab or whatever. And again, it will go interactive with the gaming and this and that.
Sir, yeah, I have a question. As an entrepreneur, you know, the typical problem everybody faces in a country is the mismatch of skills and the business opportunity. We don't have the right kind of skilled people and we have the business work, so there is a total mismatch. And I think to a great extent it goes to our education system also, and the government, which is particularly responsible for this, for not setting up the right kind of environment where you can go and acquire this business domain knowledge. I think you acquired the business knowledge by going to US and learning those skills. So what are you doing to bridge this gap? And are you part of any co-chair committee which is trying to, especially in the animation industry? The reason I am trying to tell you is this. Sometime back I saw a Facebook page on animation industry where people have created a Facebook page that says don't get frauded by the animation institutes.
I share the chair for Animation and Gaming Committee at MCCI, and for this particular aspect that we have been working towards that for a long time. The Animation Institutes are privately owned institutes, and with the MCCI's committee, there is no authority for us to go there and probably shut down their business. Personally, yes, I can blame them, but I would rather blame a student more than the institutes, because they are the ones who choose to go there. It's not the other way around. And there is no enough homework that they can do rather than, you know, just going there and do it. Those are the false numbers or the false ideas that they would think of. And, you know, a year and a half is not a time that you can invest in your career and say that, you know, this is going to be my lifetime thing. It's too of a smaller or shorter time. So I have got students to blame for it. We are trying to bridge the gap in a sense that there are awareness programs here every day. Not every day, but every month or the alternate month. There is an animation day, there are speakers. Plus there are several other things which have been done with the collaboration of every studio in Pune. There has been a course syllabus which has been developed. So people can go through that course syllabus. We can only advise and urge and suggest these institutes to have at least some kind of a test for somebody to enter into your institute. So there has been 750 questions which have been designed in terms of logic, statistics and design, whereby one person can actually say that yes, I am eligible for this particular thing. And you know, it's a, as I said, it's a computer is a very easy thing to learn, or the software is a very easy part. So a student has to decide and particularly go to either a film school or a design school and then probably take up animation or visual effects. It's happening the other way around. If you can't do anything or if you want to, you know, get a job right away, there are several different opportunities in this business. Even we say that whenever that we say visual effects, there are some companies who are into, let's say, stereoscopic conversion, which is a great business thing today. There are 3D TVs which have come up, so there is no 3D content for it. So every cinema has to be converted into 3D. There is a huge kind of business in that. But it's a very labor intensive and a very small process called rotoscopy, which we probably use in some cases while doing visual effects for films. So if people are saying that I want to do this and saying that I am in this industry, it's a very, you know, false perception. And if you're trying to teach yourself according to the job that you're going to get,